Hello and welcome to another episode of Eliphas Leary's Lectures About Magic. In this episode I thought, talking about religion might be a good thing. As you might remember in another from another video of mine, I studied comparative religions or religious studies for some years, and during that time I learned quite a lot of different definitions of religion. My favorite definition of religion, and the definition I want to talk about in this video, is from a guy called Gustav Mensching. And it's a bit hard to translate that definition into English. I'll try my best. Mensching said, religion is the experience-like encounter, sounds strange, with the sacred, and the replying action of the person that is defined by the sacred. Now basically this definition consists of three different parts. First of all, there is the encounter with the sacred. That might be a personal encounter, or an encounter that someone is told about, like for example in Christianity, all the stories from Acts. There are parts of Christianity that try to give the believer his own personal experience, but in a controlled environment called church. Now that's the first part, the experience of the sacred, or with something sacred. The second part is the replying action, and the third part is the person determined by the sacred. The replying action and the person determined by the sacred means that from that experience rules and an expectation of how the world should be is derived. So, well, you can see that in almost every religion, well, I would say in every religion, that someone had an experience and says the world has to be like this and we have to behave like this and that, and so on. You know the grill. Now, why is that important for a magician? First of all, I think it was Terence McKenna who said that culture is like the operating system of the consciousness. But beyond that, there is another level. You could say the bios, that's religion. For example, we have the French culture, the British culture, the Scottish culture, the German culture, or German cultures. They are different from each other, but beyond that, they all come from a Christian background. Christianity is the level beyond that. In the same way for Islam, and Judaism and Buddhism and so on. What is the sacred? That's an important question. Crowley said something like, the sacred is something that is not allowed to be questioned. The sacred is, so to speak, the major dogma. When you think about the sacred, don't question it. Don't try to analyze it, don't try to figure out what it really is. Kneel before it and pray to it. And since magic is a personal attempt to get access or to make an experience with the sacred, first part of Mensching's definition, I think it's problematic to cope with the result, the revelation of something that might be considered as truth or something like that. And believing that from that experience one is determined to act in a special way. I think for a magician it's very important not to fall into that trap, but to be ready to question the sacred and to analyze the experience. You could call that banishment. And as a matter of fact, it's a very important part of banishing after a ritual, to question your experience, to try to attack it with Occam's knife. Occam's knife, or Occam's razor, is, so to speak, the best analog to the sword of the magician, the magical weapon of the element air, which is the mind, reason. Well, I think that's all for this video. I hope it wasn't too dry and too off topic, but as I said, did I say it? Well, I'll say it now. Religion is, from the view of the world that religion offers, and the symbolism and all that, is most of the time the basis for magical operations. Just remember all the god names and the Kabbalah and Christian Kabbalah and Rosicrucianism and all that stuff. Most symbolism in magic is derived from religion. And that's why it's important for a magician to learn something about how science perceives religion. Well, before I ramble on much more longer, I'll just end this video, and I wish you everything good. Enjoy your time, enjoy your day, and enjoy yourselves. See ya.